Well, good evening, everyone. My name's Luther. It's my absolute privilege to be the director of Year 13. And tonight we launch our Year 13 mission to Fiji for 2016. So thanks very much for being here. Now, I've got to say, Year 13, we absolutely love Fiji. Right? We love what God has enabled us to do there over the last 8 years. We love the fact that we've been able to take 480 students before this over to Fiji. We love the way that our month in Fiji changes us. We love the impact that we're able to have in Fiji. And we really love and appreciate the support that all of you give to all of these guys, the fact that they're able to spend a month over there on a mission for the Lord Jesus. And so tonight, we want to actually take you on a bit of a tour. Right? I want to take you on a bit of a tour. So there's a bit of a map of Fiji that will come up. And I want to give you, we want to give you a bit of an insight of what we'll be doing in Fiji, the people that we'll meet, the communities that we'll engage in, the churches that we'll get to partner with and reach out with. Because ultimately what we want to happen in Fiji is we want to grow in our love and knowledge of God. We want to encourage the Fijians to live for Jesus in everything that they do. And we really appreciate your support and all of that. So all of you who have come tonight, you are the family and friends and supervisors and mentors and supporters of this year's Year 13 crew, and we're really thankful that you're here. But can I say that of all the things that we do in Year 13, we want Jesus to be the absolute focus. And so let's stand and sing of the amazing hope that we have in our Lord Jesus Christ. Let's sing together.
Thank you.
everyone. Now, in 43 days, we get on a plane. We're excited about that. This year, 128 of us are heading to Fiji, 105 students and 23 leaders are heading to Fiji. Now, in order to get ready for that, we need to do two things. We need to get our heads ready. We need to understand what we're going to do. We need to get our hearts ready. The motivation, the preparedness of us to be ready to spend a month pouring ourselves out for the sake of other people and the Lord Jesus. And we just spent a great week at Stanwell Tops. We call it Fiji Training Week. That's what we do during that week. We get our heads and our hearts ready. We learn what it's like to engage with Fijian culture. We learn a little bit about the culture. We help these guys work out how they're going to engage. We get prepared to how we're going to share the gospel in Fiji. We look at what it means to be a leader of God's people. We also just get our hearts ready as we look at the scriptures together and sing together. It was a great week. It's also a week when all of these guys, our block students, our interstate and international students, come back for the second time. And I've got to say, I noticed that this group really bound together really close in the last week. And so here's a bit of a video to show you what we got up to a couple of weeks ago.
Though the tears may fall, my song will rise to you. Though my heart may fail, my song will rise to you. While there's breath in my lungs, I will praise you, Lord. In the dead of night, I'll lift my eyes to you. Though the waters rise, I'll lift my eyes to you. While there's hope in this heart, I will praise you.
Holy Spirit, in preparation Please give us humility so that we don't go to Fiji thinking that we know everything. Grant us wisdom that we might know when to move and when to hold ourselves back from something. Thank you for going ahead of us and for being at work in the people we meet and the relationships we will continue. We continue from previous years. Thank you that you prepare us for every good work. May we glorify you. Once again, thank you for the encouragement that Fiji Training Week was for us. In Jesus' name, amen.
As soon as we land in Fiji, we get the pleasure of going to a place called Sumbedo Youth Camp. And it's there that we actually start to sort of get embedded into the culture of Fiji. We visit villages, we visit youth groups, we spend time in churches. We also have the massive privilege of being part of a ministry at Treasure House. That's a ministry that serves children and disabled children who cannot live with their families. We're part of another ministry at a place called Lolomo House, which means love. And that's a place where mothers and their children who have been outcast from their communities can be loved and cared for in the name of Jesus. We also get to go to a remarkable place called Bar Boys Home, which is a place where young Fijian boys who have been abandoned on the streets or have been removed from their families go to school, to live, to be raised by those who love Jesus, to learn a trade, and ultimately to leave the home independent and with the love of a family. And so these first few days that we spend in this camp, sort of we dip our toes into Fijian culture, but it's really getting us ready for the rest of our mission in Fiji. And just recently, we did another video, and we sort of asked the students how they were feeling as they were heading, and how they were hoping to grow as a result of our time in Fiji. So check this out.
Born into the hands of sin.
I'm really excited to go to Fiji and see all of my fellow year 13ers grow together in God and be dependent on God and each other.
I'm nervous of how I'll be able to cope with it spiritually and emotionally.
I'm really excited to build relationships with the people over there and serve God in a different culture.
I'm nervous that I won't have the courage or the tools to share the gospel as God wants me to.
I'm really excited about seeing more about God's universal mission, particularly as it plays out in Fiji. Also supporting the people as they recover from cycling Western and just loving them.
I'm excited to connect with Fijian locals and gain an understanding of a culture that's so different from our own.
I'm excited about going to another country and seeing people who live in a culture so different to mine, and yet they love the same God, because God is so ridiculously powerful and skits that, like, he doesn't need one culture or one way of worshipping him. It doesn't matter what you do, it all matters is that your heart is loving the same God.
I think I'm most nervous about adjusting to the culture in Fiji and being able to share Jesus and show Jesus' love, but still respect their culture.
Grow my dependence on God, because I think it's very easy in our society, living in Australia, to be very sucked up in material possessions.
I'm hoping to grow in my confidence in sharing the gospel with people from other cultures.
I'm hoping to grow in my faith and learning how to serve God better.
I hope to grow in Fiji in my complete trust of God, no matter what happens, and I just trust He has it all under His control.
I really want to grow in my love and knowledge of Jesus, and I really want to kind of expand my capabilities and how I can serve at church and in schools.
I hope to grow in Fiji in the way that I'm bold about Jesus. I think being in a situation where I'm telling people about Jesus overseas will translate into how I tell people about Jesus in Australia.
I'm just going to pray for the students as we engage in the culture in Fiji. So please bow your heads. Dear God, we thank you so much for the program that is Year 13 and that we have the awesome opportunity to go to Fiji this year.
I pray for all the Year 13 students as we engage with the culture in Fiji, as we go over there to a completely different environment and setting, that we will be able to settle in quickly and adjust. We know that it's going to be tricky, but we ask that the initial culture shock will be minimal and that it won't inhibit or make us incapable of our ministry. Please help us to embrace the Fijian culture with its differences, pros and cons, and help us to understand and utilise this culture to further our effectiveness in this mission trip and the various ministries we undertake. Similarly, please help us to adjust back to this culture when we return to Australia. Please help us as we go that we won't just be a group that goes on mission, does our own thing and then leaves, but rather a group that goes, learns and grows, helps the local church, and leaves a lasting impression for Jesus. We pray that you will work through us, that we will be able to help the Fijians to grow in knowledge and love for Jesus, and that these experiences will deepen our knowledge and love for Jesus too. Amen.
If the students have sort of dipped their toes in for the first few days in Fiji, the next few days we throw them headlong into Fiji life. What we do next is we split into two teams. Year 13 is getting so big that we can't all travel around together. And so that means that Red Stream and Block Mode, our interstate students, they then head to a place called Nasakawa Vision College. And then our Blue Streamers will head up to the North Island of Fiji to a place called Lembasa.
Yes!
And Lembasa High School is where Adam's going in particular, and others. Now, it's a massive privilege to go to these schools. Just to tell you a little bit about Nasakawa Vision College, it was actually established by the Korean Methodist Church Mothers Union. Okay? They have planted churches and established schools throughout the world. Okay? They are prolific, okay, in their ministry. And a remarkable school in Nasakawa Vision College was started a number of years ago. We get to go there every year. And every year, they give us the opportunity, they give us unlimited access to speaking to the students. We literally teach the Bible to hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of students throughout the 3 days that we are there, and it's an amazing opportunity. But not only that, we go home and we live with the students' families, and so each day these guys will travel home from school with the students to their villages that are scattered around Nasakawa Vision College, and it's a remarkable experience. There's one thing that they'll notice is that in buses in Fiji, people don't wear headphones because they're a communal culture, they're not an individualistic culture. And so there's massive blasting out of the speakers of the bus, Western music, okay? And as soon as they hear that, they'll realise a couple of things about Fiji. One is that they are massively influenced by the culture that we're influenced. Australian culture, American culture has made its way to Fiji, and not all of it has been a great influence there. But hopefully, our hope is that as these guys live for Jesus, as they show that there are Aussies who are 18, 19 years of old age who love him and want to serve him, that they're not influenced by the things of our world that are coming in via the media, but they actually see people who know Jesus and love Jesus, and for 3 days they will live for those families. Now this year we get another opportunity to go to a new high school in the North Island of Fiji called Lembasa. And it's a great opportunity to go to a new place to reach new people and new villages, which is just a great privilege. Now, truth be told, Fijians love to dance. Okay? Now, in effort, can I say effort to, I can't dance, okay? I would be exiting the stage very quickly. But in an effort to engage with Fijian culture and to show that we love their culture and that we want to embrace it, we've learned a dance that we're going to use in the schools when we're there. So as they come on stage, encourage these guys as they cheer for a dance.
Thank you.
Tony Wright is a CMS missionary that's him and his family
and his new son. And they have a remarkable ministry amongst the uni students of Fiji. We get to spend time with the uni students, we share our stories with them, we teach with them, we understand what life is like for a uni student in Fiji. It's also clear, and you would have heard, that Cyclone Winston this year has had an enormous impact on the people of Fiji. Just to give you an idea of the scope of the impact, 160,000 people had to go to shelters as a result of Cyclone Winston, which is approximately 20% of the population of Fiji, had to leave their homes as a result of the cyclone. Some of the villages that we go to in particular, Maniava, which is central Fiji, about 40 minutes by four-wheel drive only up a road in the north of Fiji. Namui Munda, which is a beachside village in the northeast of the main island of Fiji, but also Tabiuni, a new village that we will go to this year, were devastated by the cyclone. Many homes were lost, the vast majority of their family lost everything that they had. Cyclone Winston was the strongest cyclone ever recorded in the Pacific. The winds were up to 370 kilometres an hour. So as a result, one of the main things that we'll be involved in when we go to Fiji is not quite what you think. We will be involved in some of the rebuilding efforts because some of the villages that we go to don't have houses for us to stay in. And so we'll be helping not only rebuild the villages, we'll also be staying in tents like the people of the village. And so that work we will do. But what the village leaders and what the pastors are constantly saying to us is what they want most from us is for us to share the gospel of the Lord Jesus, because that's what they need the most. If you ever have the chance, watch Fiji One, which is the Fijian television station. And if you see a lot of Fijians interviewed about their experience of the cyclone, it's remarkable how often they say, "But we know that the Lord is with us. We know that He loves us in the Lord Jesus. We are so thankful." And it just strikes you to the heart because you realize how little they have, and yet how enormous their hope in Christ is. And so we just want to partner with them and share with them and do whatever they would like for us to encourage them. In particular, please play for their children. Many of the children in the villages of Fiji who went through the cyclone are traumatised, and they've never seen anything like this. People in the villages are saying our children are getting up in the middle of the night, they're having nightmares, they went in bed, they're doing all these things that they've never done before because they're traumatised and they don't know how to deal with an experience like this. And so pray that we might be effective in comforting them in that time. But one of the other things we get the privilege of doing through our ministry in Suva is working with a man named Dean Claude. He is the dean of the cathedral in Suva. And here's just a bit of a video from him, and he's talking about, I guess, the impact that our mission is able to have in the last 3 or 4 years in connection with his church. So,
Bulla, my name is Claude, and I serve as the Dean of the Holy Trinity Cathedral here in Suva, Fiji. I've been in partnership and working together with Year 13s for a number of years now, 4 years to be specific, and we've seen many great things happen. We've been involved in activities such as leaders in training, youth exchanges and youth services. We've had visitation and ministry to villages and a couple other areas in here in Fiji. And we've seen many great things happen. Number one of the benefits, many benefits of it, is that the gospel continues to be proclaimed. And that's really very fundamental to our partnership. Number two is that leaders and people who call themselves Christians here in Fiji and leaders, they continue to be encouraged and their gifts begin and continue to be stirred up. They're the ones, you know, when we have visitations to the villages, there's just great things happen. There's, you know, people get encouraged in their Christian faith. Just to see people from beyond our shores come and just worship, pray, live with them. The gospel continues to be declared. Lives have been being transformed. And one of the great things is that when Year 13 leaves, you know, the promises of gospel, where of scriptures, where the word of God does not return void. You know, their lives are being changed dramatically. You see the changes after they live, and so we're thankful to God for that. And I'm sure also the young people that come, Year 13s that come, their lives have been touched and transformed. So, you know, well, in addition to the gospel being proclaimed, people are being stirred up to live out and to share the Christian faith, and people's lives are being transformed. There's also the church is being encouraged, because we see, and especially the young people of our churches here in Fiji, they see other young people from Australia coming in, and they say to themselves, what an amazing thing to see young people who decided to spend a year of a certain portion of their life, you know, doing gospel and exploring ministry and things like that. And so, we look forward to continued partnership with the E13s. And I, for one, continue to be inspired, continue to be encouraged, and even so, I'm trying to, the next couple of years, using the same model that E13 uses, maybe what we can actually have it in Fiji here in the churches. So we look forward to it. And probably one of the biggest things also is the partnership in the churches. It's the body of Christ coming together to encourage, to teach, and to proclaim the gospel. I think that's one of the greatest benefits. So really, encourage young people to join, and thank you, parents, for speaking to and allowing your children to explore one of the greatest things in their life, and that is to become ambassadors of the gospel of Jesus Christ. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Michael Hine, and I'm on staff here with U13. It's my pleasure to introduce you, probably what we think of, to let you know them. The first is this young lady here. What's your full name?
Leanna Grace
McNeil. And what stream are you in, Leanna?
I'm in Grad Street.
We're a bit slow in Grad Street, it seems. What church do you come from?
I go to Oak Flats Anglican Church.
Where is Oak Flats? I'm not sure people know.
Okay, so Wollongong, it's like mid-high up, so it's south of Wollongong, about half an hour.
Cool.
Yeah, awesome place to
live. How do you hope to grow in Fiji?
Oh, alright, so I'm so blown away whenever people come back from mission trips and they just like have this buzz about them and they're so excited and they're passionate. So I want to be able to be like that. I want to be able to go away and be changed and come back a different person, like emotionally but also spiritually. I struggle doing hard things. I'm the kind of person that likes it when it's easy and simple. But I think for me, I really want to be pushed out of my comfort zone and grow. Whether it be doing picking up rubbish or doing dirty jobs, to actually putting myself out there and sharing my faith to people who I don't even know, and in different countries around the world, which is great. Yeah.
What are you nervous about? What are you excited about?
So I really hate sharks a lot, as you know me. So my instant reaction would be like like the plane ride over there, like the sharks in the water, and then they could like, if we crash, we die, and the sharks.
Sharks and lasers are worse.
But I'm actually more nervous about other things, surprisingly. It's a long time away, and I get fucking sick, and I think it's a quite intense period of time with a lot of people, really special, but full on, and I get quite emotionally drained. So I'm a little bit worried about that. But I know it's going to be really emotional and a full-on time, but I'm also super keen. I'm excited about meeting my homestay family. I'm really keen to go and to get to know what they do. Like, we're there for 9 days or something like that. And so I really see how they do simple things like cook breakfast or have little conversations over dinner. Also, the place I'm staying at in Singatope, I think it's it. we are going to a school, and we've actually been with 1,900 students for scripture, which is a crazy amount. And that's a lot of people. In like 2 days, we're going to be having all these kids speak about Jesus, which blows my mind. 1,900. This like the auditorium seats 1,000. That's like 1,900 people. So I'm really excited to like say, hey guys, Jesus is awesome. Well, like,
sounds good. What do you hope to learn about God through this scripture?
Local mission-wise, I hope to see how he works around the world. I can see a little piece of his work in our country, but actually see how through hard times, he's always there. I think, in my personal with my faith, I hope to actually use what we've learned here on campus, so whether that's Bible in a year, whether that's ethics or little conversations like that, I hope to actually implement them, and therefore learn about God more. God is awesome, and He uses the unexpected for His own glory, and so I hope to, learn things about Him.
Skits, thanks, Leanna.
I see.
please welcome our special guest speaker tonight, Chris Braga, the chairman of Youth Works, and also a round of applause for him. Now Chris, rumour has it that you have a special connection with this year's Year 13. Is this true?
Luther, I have two special connections.
Yeah.
I'm uncle to Emily and father to Rose.
They're out there.
They all look the same. Sitting there all the time. I felt pretty stupid.
Now for me, this is not an isolated experience. On holidays, just the other week, I forgot this. Okay, can you guys see that? Okay. It's the leg rope from my surfboard. Yes, I surf. Let me show you a picture. That's right, that's not me. But that's what it looks like to surf. But without the leg rope, my experience of surfing looked a bit more like this. And quite frankly, the board was at the beach half the time. And mind you, the leg rope, if I had the leg rope, it wouldn't have exactly helped me out much either. It's really important to remember to take the right things with you. When I go hiking, I've got a nerdy spreadsheet, because I don't want to end up in the middle of nowhere without the thing I was after. If you want a copy of this, I'll email it to you later. It's really important to remember to take the right things with you. Now, when the year 13ers go to Fiji, there's one thing they really need to take. One thing I want to remind them of tonight. Okay? Now, most Aussies think of Fiji as one big resort island. Is this not the case? Fiji equals resort. So, you know, if that was the case, you'd have to remember your swimmers, you know, taking a book to read, the sunscreen, that kind of stuff. But look, sorry to burst the bubble. Fiji is not one big resort. Fiji is a developing country. Fiji is a country with a large sector of subsistence farming, with almost 900,000 people called home. Think of Swaziland or Guyana. Swaziland, Guyana. That didn't help you any, did it? No. Okay, didn't hear. Okay. But as a country, Fiji is filled with people. Fiji is about people. People who have hopes and dreams, sadnesses, grief and despair. Children, work. Fiji is filled with people. And now, given that Fiji is not a big resort, but filled with people, what is it that you must remember to take with you? What is it you must remember to take with you and take to these people? What is it that you mustn't forget? You can pick a whole bunch of things, but if you're guessing what's in my mind, the word is grace. You need to have an experience of grace and show grace. It's grace that comes through Jesus. An overflowing generosity to others. And the Bible uses the term grace to talk about God's attitude to us, an attitude of favour that we don't deserve. It's His generosity. And I want to talk about you experiencing grace and you showing grace. Now, what does it mean to experience grace? The Apostle Paul writes to a church in Ephesus, and he opens the letter by talking about grace. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. That is, God has shown His grace to these people. They've come to know Him as their Heavenly Father. Now, Paul describes this grace a few verses on, verse 7. In Him, that is Jesus, we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of sins, in accordance with the riches of God's grace that He lavished on us. God's generosity, His grace, is seen in the death and resurrection of Christ and what that achieves for us. Now, when verse 7 talks about redemption through His blood, it's saying that by Jesus' death, He's paid the price to bring us back to God. And that idea of redemption, of buying us back, has a parallel idea in that verse, the forgiveness. What's forgiveness? Our wrongdoing, our sin, our rebellion against God stand against us. A record that stands against us. And forgiveness is when that record is no longer held against us, when it's let go, when it's wiped clean. And by Jesus' death, He wipes clean the wrong we've done before God. But it doesn't stand against us any longer. And that He died in our place for our sin. And it wasn't a small thing to bring that forgiveness. He took the death of His own Son. A big thing. Immense generosity. Immense grace that God has shown. Undeserved grace that He lavishes on us. I love pavlova, right? I love baking. Okay, so I love baking pavlova. You know, egg whites, caster sugar, cornflour, vanilla essence, vinegar. Don't just put them in equal amounts, it won't work. Mix it up the way my mum used to bake it. It's not pavlova yet, is it? You need cream. And you don't just use a small amount of cream. You lavish, you dunk the whole thing in it. It's like my pavlova that's sunk in the middle, and you just put more cream in to fill the gap. It's lavish on it. And then you put the fruit on top. And you just lavish that cream on. Otherwise, it's a little pavlova. And God, He lavishes His grace on us. He doesn't skip back, doesn't hold back. And the picture that Paul paints of His redemption, of His forgiveness, is also a statement he talks about generosity that brings us from death to life. Chapter 2, verse 3, the one we read from. Like the rest, we were by nature deserving of wrath. That is, we're all sinners and deserve the just judgment of God and face His anger. That's what it's saying. But verse 4. But because of His great love for us, God, who is rich in mercy, made us alive in Christ, even when we were dead in transgressions. It's by grace that you have been saved. As we're dead, deserving God's judgment, and brought to life because of this generous activity of God in Christ. He made us alive with Christ. By grace you have been saved. Those that don't deserve life are given it. You're not saved from God's judgment by being born into the right family, or from the right ethnic group, or living a good life. The only way you're saved from God's wrath on the day of judgment is because of the grace of God shown to you in the Lord Jesus Christ. It's a gift. It's a gift to you. God's generosity is a gift that you receive. And when you turn to God, His grace can deal with any sin. His grace can redeem any person. His grace can bring life to anyone. Sometimes it's easy to think of God's grace as being like a resource that's going to dry up. Now, there's a lot of coal on the earth, right? But it's going to run out one day, so you've got a great big coal mine, and you're going to think, well, there's a lot of it. That's up in the Hunter. Pretty scary, isn't it? There's a lot of it, it's not going to last forever. It's a bit like a bag of chips, just the chips are a bit smaller. But even though it says there's more to share, that's not a big bag of chips. It's going to run out pretty fast. It's not going to be there. Grace is more like a messy bedroom, okay? There's never any supply of grace, okay? God's grace trumps anything, okay? There is a never-ending supply of messiness. Just ask any mother, okay? Now, my daughter, I didn't tell her I was going to do this. My daughter, Rose, has a fairly small bedroom. Know me already, that's not it. I told you she didn't know I was going to do this. No, that's not it, okay? There is a never-ending supply of messiness. The world just ends up messy, okay? But God's grace is deliberate and it extends and abounds. Death does not win. Grace wins. God lavishes His grace on us in the Lord Jesus Christ. To those that trust Him. That's what He does. And we want you to experience that grace. And if you haven't experienced that grace tonight, we want you to know that generosity that God has shown you in the Lord Jesus Christ. If you guys are near 13, we want you to have another experience of grace. It comes from that first, really. The grace of receiving our generosity in sending and supporting you. And Youth Work sees it as an important part of your mission trip. For you to be supported financially and sent by those who fund you and love you. And I trust that this experience is one which encourages you and shows you the partnership and relationship that you have with the people in your life. And friends, as these young people go to Fiji, give your money. Be generous. Let them experience your generosity in sending and supporting them. And we want you to have that experience. Of grace, that experience of generosity. Well, now having experienced the generosity of God, God will experience our generosity towards you. We want you to show that grace to others. I'm certain there'll be times in Fiji when you're frustrated, when you're angry, when you feel like snapping at others, bearing a grudge against people. But remember the grace that God has shown you. Paul says later in the same book, chapter 4, verse 31, get rid of all bitterness, rage and anger, brawling and slander, along with every form of malice. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as in Christ God forgave you. For this generosity that God has shown you, in forgiving you, is now to be extended to others and shown to others. It's also about men speaking about it. Speaking about this message of God's grace. And as you speak these words about Jesus, let them be filled with the content of the good news of Jesus, and let them be filled with the character of grace. And we want to encourage you to share this message as you speak about him and live out what it means to be his followers. So now you're going to be making a list up, okay, when you leave. Don't forget grace. It's not going to have you packing your bag, okay? It's going to be in your head and in your heart. It's not going to be like a leg rope you forget or a Visa card you forget or whatever else. But make sure that you don't forget the grace of God that he's shown you in the Lord Jesus and have it shaped your heart as you share that with others. As you work together with the churches you'll be visiting and as you work with each other. May the grace of God shape every step you take. And the Apostle Paul, he finishes the letter of Ephesians speaking about grace. He says this, grace to all who love our Lord Jesus Christ with an undying love. Friends, may God give you an experience of his grace that leaves you equipped and ready for Fiji and eternity. Amen.
Thanks, Chris. Really appreciate that. It is so true. Can I say that one of the absolute highlights of our time in Fiji has to be the 9 days that we spend in our 9 or 10 days that we spend in our local church missions. We break into many teams. We go to many different parts of Fiji. Our local church missions are really the time that has the biggest impact on us. But it's also the opportunity where we get to have the biggest impact, because it's really the time when we deeply immerse ourselves into local Fijian life. We live with the villagers, we live amongst their churches, we love and we serve them. Just to let you know on the map where we're headed to Drakedi and Lambasa,
yes!
And Tabiuni, yes! Island. We're heading to Singatoka, yes! To Manila, yes! To Maniava, yes! To Malabao. That long in each of these villages. It's true that these villages do not welcome in other people from different parts of the world. We have access to these villages in a way that no one else does, and that is primarily due to the work of Wayne Tildesley, but also the rest of our leaders. So could I get all of our local church mission leaders to stand? Many of these are staff of youth, but most are volunteers who come to give their time and their efforts to take these guys to Fiji. Okay, that's just speaking right at the back there. Yeah, just talking to Matt, all right. Now, it's true that we get to work with the local church. We get to preach in their churches. We get to teach their children. It's a great chance. Some guys will get to play rugby with the Fijians. They're praying for safety and mercy, right? The good thing about playing Fijian rugby is that they hit you harder than you've ever been hit in your life. But because they love Jesus, they kick you up off the ground with a smile and say, "You okay, brother?" And then they hit you even harder again. I retired from rugby 20 years ago, so you can have a chance to meet you. But yeah, the other thing the Fijians love to do is they love to sing. They are famous throughout the world for their singing. They will break into six-part harmony at a moment's notice, unlike our Euthanians, but they can sing too, right? We're just speaking the truth, in grace, okay, if you remember that. This year's Euthanians have written a song we're planning to sing in Fiji when we go to the villages as an Australian attempt.
and embracing their culture, and so will you sing with us? They want you to sing with them now. So this is a song we've written specifically for our mission. So sing with us. And we need to wait for a singer.
Maintain and further develop the awesome partnerships Year 13 has made with the villages, And especially we pray for our teams heading to Tabi Uni and Mombasa, as it's the first time we've visited here. And we ask that we would build great relationships with local people and churches that would serve to be a blessing. Father, I pray that over the next couple of months in preparation to Fiji, and while we're there, that you would bless us with energy, strength and good health. Lord, may each and every one of us be completely dependent on you for all these things. Thank you, Lord, that you bless us, mere sinners, to play a part in building your kingdom. So we ask that this short-term trip would serve the greater long-term mission in Fiji, and that we bear fruit for your glory. And Jesus, and we pray. Amen.
Now, I have to say, one of the amazing things about the opportunities that we have to go to mission in Fiji is that we get to partner with you. Like, the vast majority of the people in this room will not be on the plane with us in 43 days' time. We can, on behalf of the students, can I say, not thank you that you're not coming, because we'd love you to come with us. But we want to say thank you for your support, for your partnership, the way that you will pray. I know, because you will pray for these guys. I know that you are, many of you are giving to support them, and there are countless people who aren't here tonight who are giving financially to support the students to go on their mission. They're not going on a holiday. We would never ask anyone for money for a holiday. The reason why the students ask you to support them financially is because we're going on a mission. Because we're going there on behalf of the Lord Jesus to proclaim his name and to live and share the gospel with those in Fiji. And so thank you. Thank you for the way that you've shared so generously to enable this group to go. That is fantastic. But one of the best ways you can actually be informed throughout the time that they're in Fiji is to sign up for what we call the Bullet Blog. I'll show you how you might do that later on. But that will be an email that can come to your inbox. It will let you know what we're up to, both in our preparation over the next 43 days, but also throughout our time in Fiji. It'll give you updates on what you can be praying for and how you can be supporting us. So I'd really love for you to sign up to the Blue Blog, and I'll tell you how to do that. But there's something I want to ask of you, something that I flagged last year at our graduation of Year 13, and that is, of course, this year there's been a devastating cyclone that I talked about before in Fiji. It has meant that the opportunities that we have to train leaders in the gospel to serve the villages has only been enormously magnified. The opportunity that we have as such a large group from Australia to go and the impact that we can have is enormous. And so this year in particular, the people of Fiji need us. But most of all, what they need is exactly what Chris was talking about. They need to know of the grace that God has shown to us in the Lord Jesus Christ. They also, as a church, need to know how to teach the Bible well so that they can spiritually feed those in the villages constantly with some of the teaching that we get. Now, can I say that one of the key factors in the success and the growing influence of the Youth of their mission has been, I think this photo is going to come up here, is Wayne Tilsley. Now, Wayne is the rector of the church in Richmond. But also, Wayne has been involved in ministry in Fiji for more than a decade. Now, if you know anything about Fijian culture, you know that Fijians are extremely relational. Nothing happens exactly like it happens in Australia. It happens because of trust. It happens because of relationships. It happens because of time. And it happens because people spend time with leaders in Fiji. Now, Wayne has done exactly that. The only reason Year 13 gets to go to the places where we go to serve the people that we do, way off the beaten track, where places where tourists never go, is because of Wayne's ministry. Now, as Year 13 has grown, Wayne goes ahead of us. He now spends 12 weeks of his year dedicated to the Year 13 ministry. He spends about 5 or 6 of those outside of the Year 13 mission trip in Fiji. Now, what Wayne does is he's already spent 4 weeks in Fiji this year. He's gone ahead of us. He's gone to Tabi Uni. He's gone to Maniama. He's gone to Nguimanga. He's gone to all of these places. He's gone to Suva. He's shot all those videos that we've seen tonight. He's continuing to establish relationships, which is key in Fiji, to maintain ministry, in order that Year 13 might continue to have the impact that we would have. If it wasn't for Wayne's ministry, we would simply not be able to go to the places that we go, and we would have nowhere near the impact that we do.
serve, to love, and to be effective. And can I say that Wayne's ministry, together with Trinette, and the two of them are like this dynamic team that worked together for many years. Okay, the reason why this mission is exploding is because of the work of those two. Now, I just want to just give you another hint. Have a look at this short video. This is a leader that Wayne has been able to influence and get us into contact with. He's the minister in Tabagini, really going.
Mula, I am Reverend Joseph Swami from Tabagini. I have served as a minister in Navua, Nasikawa for 3 years, 2 years for Dudley, and currently I was in, recently I was in Nosori, and now I'm a minister here in Tabagini. For the past few years, we've been having leaders training that was conducted in Suva, and from our churches, we've been sending leaders to attend those training. And when the leaders come back, we find that they are more effective in their leadership and also in terms of things that they do, especially the study of the Bible. They are able to relate to the context and also preach a very well sermon. So it's always good to see young people who are passionate about the Bible and who are willing and able to train other young people to be disciples of Jesus.
Now, it's because of the impact that we're having on leaders like Joseph and Dean Claude in Suva and countless others, that actually tonight I want to launch an appeal. We spoke about the end of last year. It's called the Mission Magnified Appeal. And the simple reason is this. I want to ask you for some money. Now, let me be very, very clear what I want to do. I want us to raise $25,000 tonight if we can. And the reason why I want to do that is that I want to see Wayne's ministry ahead of us in Fiji continue. Now, you may be wondering, my son, my daughter, my friend paid a whole heap to do this youth learning program. Why do I have to give any more? Well, the simple fact is this, just to be heaps honest, we try and keep the year 13 fees as low as we can, because the last thing that I want for year 13 is for the program to be a gap year program for the rich and famous. What we would love Year 13 to be is a program that's accessible for any Christian in Sydney who loves Jesus, wants to serve him and go to Fiji on mission. So because of that, we keep everything as basically as clean as we can so that the maximum number of students, as you can see, can come to this program and grow in Christ. Now as a result of that, there's all these other things that we want to do, but we want to try and raise money for them outside of the fees. And so tonight, I would love to try and raise $25,000, which is what it costs to support Wayne in his ministry and going ahead of us in Fiji. If he doesn't go, we don't have the impact that we have. And so I would really love to ask you to support him. Now, by God's grace, one man has come forward and says, all right, I'll give you 10 grand to start. So we're already almost halfway there. And he said, whoever gives tonight, we'll match dollar for dollar up to $10,000. So that's 20. So if we can manage to give $10,000 tonight as a group, then that's 20. I also think that there may be a couple of people in this room for whom writing a check or depositing money on your phone or however we're going to do it, of a few $1,000s is something well within your means. Can I say it would be money well spent? And so the other five, I reckon there's a couple of people in the room who may be able to help us raise the other five. We would be so grateful if you would partner with us in this ministry by giving to the Mission Magnified Appeal. So let me tell you how you can do it. You take out your phone. Right. Now everyone's got a phone, perhaps. Right. If you don't have your phone, a smartphone, that's the person next to you. They can give and then you can pay them back. Right? I'll let you decide as a family how this works. But if you go to, you see, there's another slide coming out, thanks Kiara. Okay, if you go to this one, year13.net/bullerblog, if you can go there right now, what you can do is sign up for the Buller blog. Now, that is the email that will come to you to let you know how to be informed about the mission. Once you've signed up for that, and I'd love everyone to do that, so even if you don't want to give, but if everyone in the room could sign up to the Buller blog so you can know what's going on during the Year 13 mission, that would be fantastic. But once you've done that, it'll actually take you to a page that will enable you, and I think Tom's going to come up for it, it will enable you to go to a page that will encourage you to give to the Mission Magnified Appeal. Now, if you don't want any of our board logs, you don't want to know what we're doing in Fiji, but you would like to give, then you can also go to the year13.net website and go to the mission magnified section, and that will give you details of how you can give. And so, please, it would be a real privilege if you would partner with us in this. Donations are tax deductible, so that $10,000 that's going to be matched is tax deductible. If you give tonight, then a receipt will come to you and you'll be able to take that into tax. And thanks to the government, they've already given you like a $6 a year tax deduction, as of last night apparently. You may want to give that towards the appeal. Thank you, Malcolm and team. But Tom's going to play. But everyone take out their phones. Please sign up for the blog. And if you would like to support our appeal, then do that right now. That would be Let me pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for your generosity to us. Father, we thank you for the generosity you've shown us in the Lord Jesus. Father, I thank you for the generosity for those who just gave. Father, I pray that as others consider giving the next few days, Father, that you would use this to continue Wayne's magnificent work in Fiji. And Father, may that be to the glory of your Son, the Lord Jesus. Amen. Thank you, everyone. Can I say that what we want to do now is we want to pray for these guys, and I want to try something a little bit crazy, right? So, not too crazy, okay? So, I'm going to get all these guys to stand. Then there's a bit of a Christian thing about sort of coming and laying on hands of people, and then sort of commission to go there. So, So a few people are going to come and pray. Amelia Begbie, one of our new staff members. Amelia's going to come and pray. Liz Newton Brown, one of our parents, is going to come and pray. Harry Crouches, Brad's, and also one of our new local church mission leaders. Going to pray. But what I'd love you to do, I'd love all the youth leaders to stand. Then what I'd like all of us to do is just to get as close as possible as you are comfortable without making bodily contact with somebody you don't want to. Place your hands on them as we pray. So come, everyone up, yeah? Come in and look. You won't be tough enough there, but just be part of this, okay? I'm going to begin in prayer, but then Amelia's going to follow, and then I'll pray again. So let's pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you that you are sending this bunch of students and their leaders to Fiji in 43 days' time. Father, we thank you for the partnership in the gospel that each of us have together. Father, we pray that you would be at work, for we know that if you're not at work, none of what we hope to achieve will happen. Father, I pray that you'd be preparing our hearts and our minds. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the privilege it is to be part of the team going to Fiji this year. We thank you for the students, each of them designed by you and brought to this point by your grace. Please, God, give the staff wisdom for the journey ahead of us. Please give us faith in your wisdom and in your plans. Remind us that you go ahead of us in all that we do. Please give us even greater joy in the company of the students and in the company of the Fijian people. Grant us an overflow of patience in frustrations, of gentleness in care, and in kindness in our talk. Please, God, grant us direction and a listening ear in conversations, and give us discernment and peace should matters of discipline arise. Make us sacrificial servants of the gospel, God. Grant us perseverance in planning. Make us sensitive to the needs of the students, and give us eyes to see the best way forward. Over all of this, Lord, please be healthy, that we might best care for the people who we are serving. We feel honoured, God, to serve you, and to serve your people in this way. We ask that you would bless our endeavours. Amen.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful evening and for the great sense of expectation and excitement that is building for the Fiji mission. Thank you for the continued opportunity and open doors that enable the Year 13 community to bless and serve and love on communities in Fiji that needs support, attention, and encouragement. What a privilege it is to do your work and to be called your servants. Father, we pray tonight for this amazing group of Year 13 students, our precious children, who are soon heading out of their comfort zone and into your global mission. We commit them into your strong, mighty hands. Lord, we ask for protection and safety as they travel through our various communities and regions. Please keep them healthy, strong, and focused as they minister, serve, and love those they encounter. God, we pray that you would overshadow them as a group and individually, that they might know your continual presence, power, and love. Please give them wisdom beyond their years, insight and sensitivity to cultural differences, and confidence and courage to face challenging days. Father, we ask that unity in your spirit would prevail, that friendships would be forged, and that the joy of the Lord would be their strength. We pray against any efforts of the enemy to discourage or tear down, and we thank you that the purposes of the Lord will not be thwarted. Take our kids, we pray, and bless them abundantly, and may your favour rest on them all moment by moment. Please bring them home safely to us, changed, enlarged, and empowered to see your kingdom come. We commit them to you now and pray these things in your Son's precious name. Amen.
Gracious Father, we thank you for the country of Fiji and the enormous privilege that Year 13 has to go there each year, to spread your word and to learn from their faith, their food, their language and culture. We think of those who have been affected over the past months by Cyclone Winston. It pains us to see the loss that has sustained and the extensive damage that has come as a result. Please be helping the people there rebuild their lives after this tragedy, especially those who have lost family and friends. Please comfort them in this time, reminding them of your love and sovereignty in these painful times. We pray for your people over there, especially those with whom Year 13 has made connections with over the last 8 years. For Dean Claude in the Cathedral, the Wright family in the Uni Ministry, Peter Schultz in his prison ministry, for Sir Kelly, for Tina, Brother Lyon, and many other faithful Christians that we've met over there, who selflessly love the students each and every year. Thank you for their faith and the way they continue to welcome and teach the students. Please be with them, Father, help them grow in their love and their knowledge of you, and to be people who declare your gospel to the nation of Fiji. We pray for the relationships the Year 13 will form with the Fijians this year. Please help them glorify you in their friendships they form and the conversations they have. Thank you for the opportunity they have to meet some incredibly faithful Christians in Fiji. We thank you for their faith and the privilege the students have to share their lives with them. We lift these people up to you and pray for them in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you that you answer our prayers, and we pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Thanks, everyone. It was amazing. We're going to sing to conclude our meeting tonight. Thank you so much for being here. It's true that what we really want amongst all of us is that Jesus would be the first in each of our hearts. We want Jesus to be the first in each of the hearts of everyone in Fiji. So let's stand and sing this great hymn and be down with you. grace that you have lavished upon us in him. Redemption, the forgiveness of sins, a purpose and a reason to live, a reason to go to Fiji. Father, we pray that you would not only help us to understand your grace, that you would help the Euthanians to live it in Fiji as we go. Father, we pray and we thank you for him. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you everyone for coming and thanks for your support.